G'day, I'm Melinda Robbins. It's me, Beth. Another week has passed, which means you get another video from Well Me here on this channel. If you haven't already read the title today, I'm stepping away from music and I'm delving into reviewing some of my favourite manga. Today's manga in question is Fire Force Volume 1. You've got to check out, you know, a few of my manga-related videos here on the channel to realise I'm obsessed with this series. Before we begin the review, though, if you want to support me and the channel in the future, you can by clicking like to show me some love. You click subscribe and tap that bell to be notified of when I upload on this channel. Enough rambling, let's just dive straight into some firefighter manga. The series starts in the year 198 of the solar era in Tokyo, and there is an epidemic of spontaneous human combustion, but instead of dying, these people are turning into infernals, who are like these like demon-like fire creatures who are hell-bent on destruction. And it's down to like the various fire force companies, you know, to, you know, not only like cure the epidemic and like find a solution, but stop the infernals before they can do any harm to society. Volume 1 opens with our protagonist Shinra waiting for a train which just so happens to have an infernal on, and instead of running away like a normal person, he ignites his feet. In the series, Shinra's nickname is Devil's Footprint because he ignites his feet. He also has a bit of a quirk, which is like a nervous smile, which earns him the nickname Devil. Though all around Shinra is a good boy, it kind of gives the audience a bit more in-depth detail into his personality, his history, and where he's going to go in the future. Anyway, Fire Company 8 roll up, led by Captain Obi, his Lieutenant Hibana, Maki, who gets easily offended, and clearly best girl of the series, Sister Iris, just wait until the Neverworld arc. Together with Shinra, they defeat the Infernal, and as the audience, we are like introduced to the fact that Shinra is Fire Company 8's new rookie. In Chapter 2, we are introduced to Shinra's rival and fellow Fire Company 8 rookie Arthur Boyle, who thinks he's a knight, and his ability is he can control plasma, he can raise the temperature of flames, which he kind of uses in a sword, which kind of adds to like the whole idea that he thinks he's like a knight of the round table, out to save damsels in distress. From my point of view, Arthur clearly has the most personality out of this cast of characters, and some will argue with me that, you know, he's not that great, but, you know, his ideas of like grandeur and like his like delusions, pretty much to a degree, he's a solid fighter and he brings something to the company that Shinra doesn't. You know, come at me in the comments, but, you know, if Iris is best girl, Arthur is best boy. Now, I'm not going to spoil the rest of the volume because I really think more people need to read this series. But, you know, in a brief few frames, we are introduced to two rather shady individuals. They don't say much, they're just there, but you can kind of tell as the reader that these are the guys you're going to have to look out for because their motives might not be entirely good, and they are going to cause some drama, which I like because I like a brief setup. I don't like being spoon-fed all my drama because it doesn't give you anything to look forward to further down the line. The volume ends with the start of the Rookie Fire Soldier Games, in which all the fire companies send their new rookies to kind of compete it out and see who's the best. For me, this is the best way to like leave the volume on a cliffhanger because it kind of makes you want to read number two, because A, you want to see the outcome of the games, plus all is not what it seems, which, you know, is drama, it's dramatic, it keeps you coming back for more. Also, in this final part, we are introduced to new characters, future plot points, and a lot of foreshadowing. You know, this whole volume 1 is a teaser start to finish for what's going to happen volume 2 and beyond. Unlike other first volumes and other series, Fire Force for me does not fall flat. It has a strong start, it keeps it interesting in the middle, and it ends on a high note. Okay, yeah, sure, apart from like Shinra and maybe Arthur, not a lot of the characters, you know, have a lot of development, but, you know, we learn enough about the ragtag Company 8 that, you know, we come away with at least two favourites. Mine personally are Arthur and Captain Obi. In the comments below, I'd love to, you know, if you've read this series or watched the anime, tell me who your favourite, you know, member of Fire Force is. It doesn't have to be from Company 8. It can be whoever you want. Just don't spoil the story too much for people who, you know, haven't read it or seen the anime yet, because that's not cool, guys. So, there we have it, guys and girls of the internet. That was just my quick-ish review of Fire Force Volume 1. I hope you guys liked it and it kind of either interests you in picking up the series or going to check out the anime, because both are equally great. I love the manga, I love the anime, I love the voice actors, so either way, if more people read or watch Fire Force, it is a winner-winner chicken dinner all around for me and other lovers of this series. Like I've already said, in the comments, tell me your favourite Fire Force member if you have read it, Also, in the comments, you know, just tell me some of your favourite manga or some of your favourite anime. Let's, like, start a conversation, because I'm not just about music here on the channel. Oh, no. I love me some good manga. I love me some good anime. So this is going to probably be, like, a more common thing in the future in terms of videos. So if you're here for the music, watch the music videos. If you're here for manga and anime, or if you want to watch both, there's nothing stopping you. Yes, let's just wrap up this video before I continue rambling. If you want to support me and the channel in the future, you can by clicking like to show me some love. You click subscribe and tap that bell to be notified of when I upload on this channel. At the end of this video, you can check out my last two videos or playlist, depending on what mood I'm in when I'm editing. I am sorry for the changing light, but the sun is clearly, it's clearly the time of the month for the sun because it cannot make its mind up. Until next week, I'm Beth. Goodbye.